Brave is just a browser like others, but with more privacy features. That's what I told myself when I first installed it. But finally, after a year of using it, I found these awesome and unique features that helped me a lot with my tasks. So here's how to use them. When you first open Brave browser, you'll see this, this, and this. But these are all distractions, so what you want to do is to hide them all. Now click on Customize to start adjusting your new tab appearance. You can change the background here, I'll leave it as is. Next, turn off the Brave stats, and for Brave news, you can leave it on, I'll explain more about it later. You can also enable the clock feature, which looks nice, and hide the cards since we won't need them. As for the search engine, you can switch to any option you prefer, but trust me, Brave Search is excellent. It offers more useful search results and far fewer sponsored listings. If your preferred search engine is Brave, but you want to search using Google, just type :G followed by your query. Similarly, to search with Brave, you can use :br. Now we have a neat and clean new page tab. The first feature is vertical tabs. Here's how to use vertical tabs in Brave. Click on one of your open tabs. Select the option for vertical tabs. Now your tabs will appear in a vertical layout on the side of your screen. If you'd like tabs to remain visible and not auto-hide, simply click on this icon and your vertical tabs will stay in place. Next, Brave Playlist is a handy feature that allows users to create a playlist of audio and video files, which can be played back later, even offline. This is perfect for saving content to watch or listen to when you don't have an internet connection. To use it, navigate to any audio or video content you want to save. Then tap and hold the media player and select Add to Playlist. Now you can access to your playlist by tapping the Brave menu and selecting Playlist. So next we have the Brave Sidebar. It's a handy panel that sits on the side of your browser window, letting you access your bookmarks, favorite websites, and Brave built-in feature with just a click. To enable the sidebar, go to Settings, then Appearance, and toggle the sidebar on. You can even customize what's in the sidebar by adding or removing items or rearranging them however you like. It's a great way to streamline your workflow and keep everything you need within easy reach. Now let's talk about Brave's Speed Reader, a feature that simplifies articles by removing unnecessary clutter. Unlike traditional reader mods, Brave's Speed Reader kicks in before the page fully loads, giving you faster load times and saving data. If Brave detects an article, you'll see a reader icon in the address bar. Just click it and the page will reload in a clean, simplified format. You can even customize Speed Reader settings like fonts and background color for the best reading experience. It's perfect for distraction-free reading on the web. Next is Brave Sync. Using Sync, you can keep all your browsing data like bookmarks and history in sync across multiple devices. Here's how to enable Brave Sync. First, go to Settings, click on Sync, and start a new sync chain by following the on-screen prompts. You'll get a sync code that you can use to add other devices to your chain. Once you added a device to your sync chain, any changes made like adding a new bookmark will automatically update across all sync devices. You can customize which data you sync in your settings, making it easy to keep everything connected or just focus on what's important. The other thing you can do with your sync chain is to send the pages open in your browser to other devices. For example, I can send the page open on my PC to my phone. Just click on this share icon and the available devices will be all here. Click on the devices you want, and this sends me a notification on my mobile and I can open it by clicking on it. So next is Brave News. Brave makes it easy to stay updated with the latest news by letting you add RSS feeds directly to your new page tab. And if you don't know what RSS is, RSS stands for Really Simple Syndication. Think of it as your personal news feed that automatically gathers updates from your favorite websites. You can either manually add an RSS feed, but if you're visiting a website offering one, look for the little RSS icon in the address bar. Click on it, follow the prompts, and you're all set. Once added, simply open a new tab and scroll down to see the latest news from your chosen feeds. Plus, Brave comes preloaded with plenty of RSS feeds for you to follow right out of the box. If you frequently read articles, you can easily save tabs for later or just keep them for future reference. Let's say I want to save this for later. Click on the bookmark icon, then select List and click Add This tab. whenever you save a tab, you can access it by clicking here or by opening your sidebar and selecting the bookmark icon. This helps you keep your reading organized and easily accessible. Many of you might already know about Brave Leo, the AI chat feature inside Brave browser. The reason I'm highlighting this feature is that you can use AI locally from your own PC or connect to an online AI API key all while browsing. This ensures better privacy and flexibility. To add your own AI model in Brave, go to Settings, Leo, and from there you can add the model you want to use. And to start using Leo in Brave, just click on the Ask Leo button in the address bar after typing a query, or use the sidebar icon to open Leo's chat interface. Once it's open, simply type your prompt into the text box and hit enter to get a response. You can also expand the full page chat for a more immersive experience by clicking on the expand icon on the sidebar. Brave has a set of hidden experimental features that you can access by entering this URL. This page allows you to enable some of the Brave's most advanced functionalities, which are still under development. Let's go through a few of most useful ones, and I'll show you how to enable them and how they work. So if you need a modern view, sleek design and smooth animation like me, you can enable these four scrolling options: fluent scroll bars, fluent overlay scroll bars, overlay scroll bars, and smooth scrolling. The other thing you can do is to enable this link preview. Link preview lets you preview a page in a small dedicated window before navigating to it. After enabling this, by holding Alt and clicking, you'll get a small preview. The next one, which is a great feature I use always, is Auto Dark Mode. This feature automatically applies dark theme to all the content in your browser. So if the website you're browsing doesn't have the theme option, you can use this feature to apply dark mode on all websites. The next two features are about downloading. Parallel downloading, which speeds up large downloads by breaking them into similar parts, and override download danger level, which removes safety warnings for risky downloads. So if you know your files are from a trusted source and don't like this error, enable this and enjoy your downloads. Let me know if you want feature reviews on any other browsers. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on any upcoming content. See you in the next video.